let us see what are the different STDs, that is a sexually transmitted diseases, and how they are aiding in the reproductive health, how much loss they are causing to the present generation. The different sexually transmitted diseases, their infections and the causal agents. Here there are many: bacterial, viral, protozoan and also ectoparasitic. Okay, not only endoparasites, ectoparasites are also present. What are ectoparasites? Which are causing the diseases externally from outside. Okay, endo means it will be from the inside. Now let us see what are the different bacterial sexually transmitted diseases. We call it as STDs, that is chlamydia, gonorrhea, syphilis, lymphogranuloma, venelum. We call it as in simple words as LV, and donovanosis, mycoplasma. These are all the genital diseases which are affected from the bacteria. Next are the viral diseases, the hepatitis A, hepatitis B, hepatitis C. All these three are the viral diseases. Now the government, not now, from the past 15 to 20 years, the government of India, central government, has been launching many initiative programs, that is immunization schedules, and immunization charts are also given at government and private hospitals. That means both government and the private organizations are trying to eliminate and eradicate certain diseases which are very, very dangerous, especially to the infants, by giving the immunization programs like polio free. They want to make polio free India. So for that reason, every year 2 to 3 times government of India is providing free polio vaccination. So apart from this, even the hepatitis injections, though they are little expensive, that must be definitely given to your kids, otherwise they will be affected with so many dreadful diseases. Even today, this hepatitis A, B, C, these vaccinations are available even for the adults, both for the male and for the female. If you see this one, HSV1 and HSV2, herpes simplex virus, these are also available now in both private and government corporate sectors. In that particular hospitals, it will be given for you even for the from the age of 9 or below for the girl child, and also for the males. Now human papilloma virus, HPV, is also a virally STD, that is sexually transmitted disease. Cytomegalovirus and also Epstein-Barr virus, hepatitis D, and HTLV, that is the human T cell lymphotrophic virus. Here the T cells will be affected, which is very, very dangerous. And the last one is molluscum contagiosum, is also a viral disease and it is a STD. Now coming to the protozoal STD diseases, it is a trichomoniasis, amoebiasis, cryptosporidium and zygardiasis. So these are all the protozoan diseases. That means these are attacked by the protozoa. Here you can say that the protozoans are acting as a vectors. Vectors means these are the disease carriers. They carry the disease from one organism to another. So majority of the protozoans acts as vectors, or they may also act as secondary hosts. Okay, so now what are then ectoparasitic? Ectoparasitic are also STDs. They are pubic lysis, scabies, candidiasis, and vulvovaginal. So all these things are ectoparasitic and causing lot of dreadful diseases.